friends, I have come here to talk to all the media, audio, visual as well as print media, about the forthcoming elections. First thing is, I mean, this has been called at a short notice. That does not mean that there is any issue with the elections. The elections are on as scheduled. So there is no surprise on that account. Our entire conversation today will be restricted to elections and elections only. So let's not go into other directions. You may have 200 things to talk to, ask about. We can do that on another occasion. But today, I'll be talking to you about three issues. One is the forthcoming elections. Two, some of the security-related aspects of the elections. Lastly, the large-scale devolution of powers, funds, functions, and functionary to the Panchayati Raj system that will be happening in the next 5 to 7 days. So let me first start with the elections. You are already aware, the notifications have been issued for elections to the urban local bodies. We have 79 urban local bodies, and the elections are to be held in 4 phases. The 4 phases, as announced, the voting to be on 8th, 10th, 13th and 16th of October, and counting is on 20th of October. As we speak, today is the last day of nominations for roughly about 1/4 of the urban local bodies, ranging anywhere between 5-6, larger ones can go up to 11-12, even up to 13. The total number of panchas in the state will be 35,000 panchas. So if you actually count the number of people who are to be elected to the panchayats, we are talking of 35,000 approximately the panchas and 4,500 sub-panchas. So we will be having 39,500 elected representatives in our panchayats. For government employees who are conducting the elections, we are, as an incentive, we are providing 1 month's extra salary. I think it was notified, SEC took a decision in the month of August end, it's been notified, 1 month's salary additional for all government servants involved in the elections is unprecedented. It's never happened before. It's probably not done in the country, we are doing it. Secondly, we have made adequate arrangements for their safety security. Coming to our own SPOs, and you have heard about the 3 unfortunate killings of, not all were SPOs, there were ex-SPOs who were then inducted into the police and others about 4 or 5 days ago in Shopian, and there were a couple of resignations. Let me put things into perspective. A couple of SPOs resigning is news, but you must see it in perspective. The state has over 30,000 SPOs. 30,000. If you compare the number of people who have resigned and what has been circulated, it is a negligible percentage of the total. Two, all the SPOs have been instructed about their personal security. Thirdly, about 2 years ago, I think in 2016, the wages of SPOs were enhanced from 3,000 to 6,000. A very serious discussion is going on right now. I'm not going to reveal the numbers because we're waiting for the decisions. The salaries or the honorarium to the SPOs are going to see a substantial jump in the next few days. I mean, 6,000 rupees a month honorarium is much lower than what even a class 4 employee of the government gets. So the SPOs are going to see an increase in their remuneration in the next couple of days. I'm committing myself to that here. I'm not committing the number because this is going to be a decision of the State Advisory Council. Candidates have picked up forms in very large numbers. As of last evening, more than 700 forms have actually been issued. As I speak, candidates are going and filing their numbers. We have asked 3-4 things together. Firstly, How many people have filed nominations? Let us wait till 5 o'clock today. The numbers will be out. As I speak, I think the first phase, in the entire Kashmir division, 175 are going to have their last date for nomination today. So if the number is more than, 175, you know that you have candidates across the state. By evening 5 o'clock, the CEO will put out the numbers.